The human brain has primary areas associated with specific functions, including movement, sensation, hearing, and vision. Damage to these areas often result in predictable deficits. But just as important as these primary areas are the pathways that connect them and larger areas which integrate their basic functions. Damage here can cause unique constellations of symptoms. Specifically, damage to the parietal lobe of the brain can cause Hemineglect syndrome. Here, people still have intact sensation and motor function in half of their body, but are unable to perceive, process, and use it. This neglect classically occurs on the left side. One of the typical examples for testing Hemineglect is asking a patient to fill in the numbers on a clock. Instead of arranging them in a circle, they might fill in the 1 through 12 only on the right side. Taking this one step further, if they're asked to draw an object from memory, they might only draw half of it. When walking, a patient might walk into objects and door frames on their left. But with the complexity of the human brain, Hemineglect is more than just ignoring the left side of their field of vision. If some patients are shown a photograph, which is upside down, they will flip it in their head and neglect the left side of the image as if it were right side up. Similarly, if shown a mirror image of the world map, they might still ignore the Western Hemisphere. Hemineglect can not only affect the way a patient interprets their surroundings, but also themselves. A patient might only shave or apply makeup to half of their face. Some have trouble grasping things with their left hand, or even their right hand, but only if they bring it over to the left side of their body. In extreme cases, a patient might even deny ownership of their own limb. And to take it one step further, Hemineglect can even make its way into a person's memories and spatial reasoning. A study in the 1970s asked two patients who were familiar with the plaza in Milan to imagine themselves standing at one end. Both patients described features that would have been on their right side. But when asked to imagine themselves standing on the opposite side of the plaza, they described features from their previously neglected side. In fact, the patients were asked about the square from various other vantage points, and were only able to describe what would have been on their right side. This suggests that the patient's memories were intact, but their ability to recall and interpret them were impaired. A study in 2010 showed a patient who knew well the geography of France, a physical map of the country. When asked to list cities in France, he named cities on the country's east side. When the map was rotated 180 degrees, he continued to name cities from the east side, even though it was in his neglected field of vision. Now, the patient was asked to imagine a map of France in his head and list off cities, and predictably, he named those in the country's eastern half. But when asked to rotate the map 180 degrees in his head, he began to list cities from the western half of France, suggesting that neglect in physical space may be distinct from spatial neglect in memory. Hemineglect is a neuropsychiatric condition with sometimes unpredictable symptoms that can vary greatly from person to person. It's the perfect example of the complexities of each section of the human brain.